Good morning, children. How are you all? Yes, today I suppose you are very well. Dear children, in our previous class, we finished the lesson, sixth unit, Allah. We finished the sixth unit, A Long Walk to Freedom. We finished the text fully. And again, once we should recall the summary. After that, in this class, we are going to have two paragraphs for comprehension. Here, in this class, we would like to introduce two comprehensive paragraphs. They are very, very important in our public examination also. So, dear children, first of all, the lesson is about patriotism. Here, we discussed about Martin Luther King. Here, he was an icon of civil rights. He was a world-class leader, and he is a most inspiring leader. Here, he got a Nobel Prize also, and then, dear children, for every person, yes, for every person, we have two obligations. The first obligation is to his family, and second obligation is to his society or to his people. So here, the fulfillment of two obligations is depending on the caliber or capacity of the individual. And then, in the initial stage, Martin Luther King felt he was born freely. He enjoyed a lot, and he did play with the stars, sand, with the rivers. He felt it's very well. But later, he came to know that the freedom which he has is not a true one. The freedom which he has is not true. It's an artificial. And then he started to change his character, his attitude towards his society, and is ready to sacrifice his life towards society. In South Africa, here, there is a discrimination between two classes, whiteies and blackies. Blackies were humiliated by whiteies. At least, black people haven't the self-respect. They can't mingle in society, and they hadn't the civil rights at least. This is called racial discrimination. So here, the black colored people haven't the chance to have the true freedom. If they tried, they must be suppressed by the whiteies. So in this connection, he came to know the real essence of the freedom, and he is thinking of that apartheid which was in South Africa, the racial discrimination between two races, whiteies and blackies. So dear children, after that he changed his attitude, and he fight for the equality and for brotherhood. And then he got the confidence and courage, and he has the roots in love, truth and peace. So he's an icon, he's an ideal person for world-class leader. So here, we should get the inspiration from the world class leader, from Nelson Mandela. Here you have to look at the paragraph. You have to look at the paragraph. In life, every man has two obligations. Dear children, you have to look at the text from the lines. In life, every man has two obligations. Obligations to his family, to his parents. From that up to, I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligations as a son, as a brother, as a father, and as a husband. Up to that, suppose now we are taking this paragraph for our comprehensive questions. Actually, I am going to share the screen of that comprehensive questions from that here. Yes, dear children, you have to look at the screen for comprehensive questions from A reading. It will be asked in our public examination also. That's why read the following passages, the lines which earlier I mentioned. Now answer the following questions. Each question has four choices. Choose the correct answer and write A, B, C, or D in your answer booklet. These are the instructions what we have to know. The first question, dear children, how many obligations does a man have? Yes, how many obligations does a man have? Here option A, 2, 3, 1, 4, like that given. Dear children, if we go through carefully the first lines of the paragraph, in every man has two obligations. Yes, the answer is there. Here, the answer is two. So option A is right answer. And second one. Now you look at the second one. How can a man fulfill his obligations? How can a man fulfill his obligations? Already we know every person has two obligations. How can a man fulfill his obligations? Here, according to his own inclinations and abilities. Yes, the fulfillment of obligation is depending on own inclinations and own ability. So the right answer is D. The right answer is D. Here easily we will get, if we go through the lines carefully, if we read once, twice, thrice like that, easily we can pick out the right answer from the paragraph. Now let's move to third one. Third question. What happened to a man in South Africa who tried to fulfill his duty to his people? What happened? What happened to a man in South Africa who tried to fulfill his duty to his people? Here, it was ripped from his family and his home. Suppose in South Africa, a person is tried to fulfill to his duty, what will be happening? Here, the people were ripped from his family and his home. Yes, that is the cruel situation was in South Africa. Next, move to fourth question. What is a twilight existence mentioned in the passage? Yes, my dear children, if you go through the lines very near to the word twilight, what is a twilight existence mentioned in the passage? Yes, their twilight, secrecy and rebellion. Secrecy and rebellion. Yes, here if you go through the the sentence from yes, in South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped from his family and his home and was forced to live a life apart, a twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. Yes, dear children, if you go through the lines, if you go through the lines, the word which is very near, easily we can comprehend and we can understand and we can pick out the right answer. So here, the right answer is for fourth one is secrecy and rebellion. The option A. Yes. These four questions are multiple choice questions. These are four multiple choice questions. We have to choose A, B, C or D among that four choices. Yes, it's possible. Just we have to understand the text carefully and we have to go through the lines and then easily we can comprehend and we can pick out the right answers from the paragraph. Next, my dears, answer the following questions in two or three sentences each. 3 to 6 marks. Here, 3 to 6 marks. The fifth one. Why is it difficult to fulfill the twin obligations in a country like South Africa? Here, the writer is supposing it's very hard. It's impossible to fulfill two obligations in South Africa. Why? What is the reason? What is the reason why they shouldn't fulfill two obligations at a time? What is the reason? What is the reason? Okay. In South Africa, colored persons were not allowed to fulfill their twin obligations, means two obligations. Here, the colored people haven't the chance. The colored people haven't the chance to fulfill two obligations. If anyone tried to do so, he was punished and isolated. Yes. From South Africa, if any person is trying to fulfill these two obligations, automatically he will be punished and isolated from the society. Blacks were not permitted to live like human beings. Yes, here black people means colored people were not allowed, were not treated as human beings. Yes, they were treated as second class people in South Africa. That is called apartheid or racial discrimination. Yes, easily you can understand if we go through the text and if we comprehend it carefully. Sixth one, who is the speaker? What did he not choose in the beginning? It's very, very easy question. Who is the speaker? Already we studied, it is an autobiography of Nelson Mandela. It is an autobiography of Nelson Mandela. The speaker is Nelson Mandela. Who is the speaker? The speaker is Nelson Mandela. He did not in the beginning choose to place his people above his family. Yes, he did not in the beginning choose to place his people above his family. Yes, he hasn't the chance. Nelson Mandela hasn't the chance to choose to place his people above his family. What did the speaker find when he attempted to serve his people? What did the speaker find? What did the speaker find when he attempted to serve his people? While Nelson Mandela was trying to serve the people, here what he had? What he had bitter experiences. He found that he was prevented from fulfilling his obligations as a son, as a brother, as a father, and as a husband. What? He was prevented. Yes, he hadn't the chance. Nelson Mandela hadn't the chance to fulfill his obligations as a son, as a brother, as a father, and as a husband. So this is about this comprehension. here. In our examination, they will supply these lines from our text, from our e-reading, and then they will ask four multiple choice questions. We have to choose. We have to choose among four choices A, B, C, and D. Four questions. Each one carries 1 marks. 4 ones are 4 marks. And again, they will give 3 short questions. Short questions. 3 to 6 marks. Each one carries 2 marks. So, dear children, what I would like to suggest to you, we have to understand the text. We have to follow the lesson carefully, and we have to read once, twice, and many times. And then we have to read the questions once and twice and thrice. We have to understand the question. And then once again, we should go through the lines, and then easily we will pick out the answers. This is the passage number 1 from A reading for reading comprehension. So, dear children, yes, dear children, now let's move to the second comprehension. Let's move to the second comprehension. Here, my dears, the comprehension passage is taken from the lines, "But then I slowly saw that not only was I not free, but my brothers and sisters were not free. I saw that it was not just my freedom that was curtailed, but the freedom of everyone who looked like I did." Yes, this is the beginning lines of the paragraph. From that up to the last lines of that paragraph, I would like to read out. "I am not truly free. I am not truly free if I am taking away someone else's freedom, just as surely as I am not free when my freedom is taken from me. The oppressed and the oppressor, oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity." Yes, these are the ending lines of that paragraph. These are the ending lines of that paragraph. Now, I am going to share the comprehensive questions. You look at the screen for comprehensive questions from this paragraph. Yes, here. Yes, here. Now read that the following passage carefully once and twice. Try to understand, grasp the message, I mean summary of that paragraph. Now answer the following questions. Each question has 4 choices. Choose the correct answer and write A, B, C, or D in your answer booklet. Yes, same model is same. 4 multiple choice questions, 4 ones are 4, and 3 short answer questions are 6. It's a second model comprehensive paragraph. Yes, first one is, "What is the way the oppressor must be liberated?" What is the way? What is the way the oppressor must be liberated? Here, they gave 4 choices, A, B, C, and D. Read these 4 choices carefully. And once again, read the question. What is the way of the oppressor must be liberated?
then easily we can pick out the right answer. That is, just as surely as the oppressed. Yeah, just as surely as the oppressed. Oppressor and oppressed. Yes, easily we can trace out these two words from our given paragraph. Just if you read carefully once, twice, or thrice. Let's move to second question. Who is prisoner of hatred? Yes, who is prisoner of hatred? Now also you read these four choices, A, B, C, and D, and then go through the paragraph. Yes, the answer is A, a man who takes away another man's freedom. Yes. If you take another person's freedom, then they will be hatred. They will be nothing but a prisoner. They will be put into a prisoner. They will be put into a prison. Who is a prisoner of hatred means? Choice A, a man who takes away another man's freedom. Next, we have to move to third question, third multiple choice question. Where is the prisoner of hatred locked? Where is the prisoner of hatred locked? If you read A, B, C, and D, yes, where is the place? Where is the prisoner of hatred locked? Here, behind the bars of prejudice and narrow-mindedness. Where is the prisoner? Where is the prisoner of hatred locked? Prisoner is locked by, yes, locked behind the bars of prejudice and narrow-mindedness. Where the people have narrow mind and where the people have prejudice. Where the people have prejudice. Next, fourth question, fourth multiple choice question. Why was the speaker not really free? Here, if you read that lines, then the writer is saying, Martin Luther King is saying, I was not free. I was not free. My freedom is not true. Like that, he's describing the lines. So, if you read that choices A, B, C, and D, easily you will get the right answer. Because his freedom was already taken from him. Because already his freedom was taken from him by others. Means by whiteys. Actually, the racial discrimination among the people of blacks and whites. The colored people, yes, they were humiliated. And there was apartheid. There was apartheid. So, yeah, because his freedom was already taken from him. His freedom was already taken from him. These are the four multiple choice questions already now we have done. Next, dear children, let's move to the fifth question. Answer the following questions in two or three sentences each. 3 to 6 marks. Yes, the first question, I mean fifth one. It was this desire that animated my life. Which desire is speakers referring to? Here, the writer is saying, it was this desire that animated my life. Which desire is the speaker referring to? The desire refers to the great hunger for the freedom of his people. Yes. The writer has a strong desire. But the hunger for the freedom. Yes. the hunger for the freedom of his people. He has great hunger. The writer has great hunger of his people. Here, he is not only thinking about his family, but also he is thinking about his nation, about his people, about his society. So, Nelson Mandela has a strong desire, strong passion, strong desire. What that? The great hunger for the freedom of his people. It's nothing but the second obligation. It's nothing but the second obligation. Next, sixth one. What does the line, the oppressed and the oppressor, oppressed and oppressor, alike or robbed of their humanity suggest? What does the line, there is a line, the oppressed and the oppressor, alike or robbed of their humanity suggest? What does it suggest? For an ordinary person, only the oppressed appears to be the sufferer. Generally, in a normal situation, for an ordinary person, only the oppressed appears. Oppressed appears to be the sufferer. But the oppressor also suffers from the hatred. Here, but the oppressor also suffers from the hatred. Hence, all are losses. Oppressed and oppressors, all they are losses. Freedom to everyone alone is the solution. So what is the solution in this context? What is the right solution? Yes, here the exact solution is freedom. Yes, freedom. Freedom to everyone alone is the solution. Freedom, everyone alone is the solution. Dear children, let's move to the seventh question. You should read carefully. Why couldn't the speaker enjoy and the poor and limited freedom he was allowed? The speaker said that his freedom has already been taken away from him. Who has taken away his freedom? Our writer is saying already freedom is taken away. Who has taken away his freedom? Who has taken away his freedom? The speaker could not even enjoy the poor and limited freedom he was allowed, because he found that his people were not free. Yes, according to him, the people were not free. The white people have taken away his freedom. Who took? The white people. Yes, from the beginning, we had been discussing while we started our first class. The white people took the freedom of colored people. Means black people. So, to destroy it, the answer is the white people have taken. The white people have taken away his freedom. These are the seven questions, my dear children. Now, I think you understood what is the way we have to follow while we will face the comprehensive paragraphs for comprehensive questions. So, in one angle, it's very easy. if we follow the class very well and if we understood the essence, the theme, the summary of the lesson, easily we will be able to give the answers. So the thing is, I would like to suggest to you, my dear children, we have to read the paragraph once, twice and thrice, and we try to understand the paragraph, and then we will go through the questions. We try to understand the questions clearly, and again we should read the paragraph once and twice, then easily we will pick out the right answers from the paragraph. Sometimes in these paragraphs they may ask synonyms or antonyms, and then some other forms also they may ask us. That's why the thing is, instead of rote what you call by heart, rote memory or by heart, we try to understand and we try to comprehend that the paragraph, then easily we will be able to give the answers. So my dear children, this is our third class. This is our third class, A Long Walk for Freedom. Here in this class, now we have discussed two comprehensive paragraphs.